Hello, dear viewers, and welcome to a new edition from your program, Body and Soul. I wish everyone a very happy Ramadan. It's a very important occasion for people to perform the rituals, to pray, to fast, and to do good deeds in order to benefit from this very holy month. Fasting is a sort of worship. It's obligatory for Muslims in Ramadan, and its observance is one of the five pillars of Islam. The month lasts from 29 to 30 days based on the visual sighting of the crescent moon. While fasting from dawn until sunset, Muslims refrain from consuming food and drinking liquids, smoking, and engaging in sexual relations. Fasting for Muslims during the holy months typically include the increasing of offering prayer or salah, or the recitation of the Holy Quran. To shed more light about fasting during the holy month of Ramadan, we are very much delighted to have our dear guest, Sheikh Husaymuddin Alam, the lecturer at Al-Azhar Mosque. Hello, sir, and thank you very much for being with us.
Thank you so much for having me, and it's always a pleasure to be with you here.
How do you see the importance of fasting during the holy month of Ramadan?
Well, in the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful, all praise is due to Allah, the Almighty, the Lord of the worlds, and may Allah's peace, mercy, and the blessings be upon His final and last messenger, Muhammad, and may Allah's peace, mercy, and the blessings be upon all of our dear viewers who are watching us across the globe, and to you here, yes. And Madam Majesty, and all the team members here, and for all the workers
Thank
here.
You very much.
Again, it's always a pleasure to be here with you, and it's an honor that you afford me, and I'd like to wish and pray for a very blessed month of Ramadan to all our dear viewers and all the great people of Egypt and all the Muslim Ummah and all our fellow human beings across the globe.
Indeed,
the heart rejoices and the mind even is at relief due to this very special and this very momentous occasion, which is the month of Ramadan, which we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it an opportunity and a time for us to prosper and to close the ranks and to get closer to all our family members and all our loved ones. And to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during this very special month to shower His mercy on all the beloved ones that we are enjoying their company nowadays, and also the ones who left. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant them all the highest rank of paradise, and also to enable us to be in their company and in the company of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, in the highest rank of paradise. Speaking of the institution of fasting, which, as you correctly mentioned in the very beginning of this episode, that it is the second of the five pillars of Islam, or the third, as a matter of fact, of the five pillars of Islam, following the Shahada and the establishment of the five daily prayers. It's a very special one because, in a very spiritual sense, it is time for physical deprivation, for spiritual ascension and elevation. It is time when the heart and the mind is in command of the body, and it is time for us to go through this rigorous process of fasting so that we can really pause to think and reflect beyond what we normally think about, and that's our very innermost and our very essence of our presence in this life.
Yes.
That are we just beings or creatures who are just here to fulfill their materialistic and physical needs, or we are far, far more beyond and more significant than that? That there are aspects of our own presence and existence that go beyond the material and superficial things that we are normally or usually engaged in. So it is during this time that we really need to think and reconsider our own presence in this life. Are we really now in a position to think and say, yes, now I can see and fathom the big picture that also my soul and also my mind has rights, and these rights need to be fulfilled. And this is why the Quran is our primary source of guidance and enlightenment. We can clearly see that the argument of when it comes to fasting and the wisdom behind it, we can see that it is very condensed and encapsulated in the Quranic verse in chapter Al-Baqarah, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly states that observing and maintaining the fasting during the month of Ramadan has been decreed and established on the Muslim Ummah as much as it was prescribed for the previous nations during the previous lifetimes of the previous prophets and the messengers, may Allah be pleased with them all. So that, and here we see the term used in the Arabic language, which is la'alla, and this is something that we also need to think about in order to be able to appreciate and understand the subtle meaning also behind it, which is la'allakum tattaqun. So here the verse starts with calling on the believers, ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, and this is to attract and to address not only the hearts or the mental faculties of the one who is addressed here, but also it addresses the heart of the one that's tackled here, and that's the believers. And this is per se is a characterization or a description that the hearts of every Muslim, the heart of every Muslim and the hearts of all Muslims get attached to and always yearns to. And that's to be described and to attain this status of being described as a believer. So we clearly see that the verse started with addressing the Muslims and especially calling them, oh you who believe. So this is more to urge us and to motivate us to really hasten towards fulfilling this obligation, and that's by observing the fasting during the months of Ramadan. And then we move on to the word kutiba, that's fasting has been decreed. And that's here to signify the obligation, or that it is a compulsory act of worship for the ones who are in a position both physically and also when it comes to their age, that if they are and once and as long as they are in a position to fast, then they have to fast and to fulfill this obligation. And also then we move on to see the verse saying that كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ, as much as it was decreed for the people before you. And also this is a very important thing, that it is not something new. And this also serves as a motive and also as a facilitation for us, that it is something that normally the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the human beings fulfill it and respond to this obligation, because it also indicates the unity of the message of all prophets and all messengers. Then the verse speaks of the wisdom or the rationale behind fasting, and this is why, this is where we see the term la'alla. And here it has a very subtle and a very delicate meaning, that here this is the wisdom, la'allakum tattaqun, so that you can, or for the purpose that you can attain this important grade and rank of being of the pious and being of the conscious people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also la'alla, it means that we need to be inspired by this, because here this is a very available chance, and if we are really to fulfill it and to live up to the requirements and the needs of what fasting takes, we will reach this end, which becoming متقين or people who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and who observe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and who are conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in everything, not only during the 30 or 29 days of Ramadan, but throughout the year.
Indeed, yes. Sir. Now we'll go towards the support about the fasting during the holy month of Ramadan, and then we'll be back to continue our interview with Sheikh Hussein Al Jilani.
In Ramadan, all Muslims except those exempted by health reasons observe fasting. However, many do it as a religious obligation, but only few know the health benefits it has if properly implemented. The psychological effect of fasting includes lowering of blood sugar, lowering of cholesterol, and lowering of the systolic blood pressure. In fact, Ramadan fasting would be an ideal recommendation for the treatment of mild to moderate, stable, non-insulin diabetes, obesity, and essential hypertension. In 1994, the first International Congress on Health and Ramadan, held in Casablanca, entered 50 extensive studies on the medical ethics of fasting. While improvement in many medical conditions was noted, however, in no way did fasting worsen any patient's health or their baseline medical condition. Those exempted from fasting have health disorders that deal with some fasting demerits. However, since fasting may cause reduction in body water called dehydration, it is not recommended for those with kidney problems, diabetes, and those suffering peptic ulcer. Also, pregnant women, nursing mothers, malnourished people, and individuals with cardiac problems are advised not to fast. There are psychological effects of fasting as well. There is a peace and tranquility for those who fast during the month of Ramadan. Personal hostility is at a minimum and the crime rate decreases. Muslims take advice from the Prophet who said, "If one slanders you or aggresses against you, say, 'I am fasting.'" This psychological improvement could be related to better stabilization of blood glucose during fasting, as hypoglycemia after eating aggravates behavioral changes. Fasting is a special act of worship, which is only between humans and God, since no one else knows for sure if this person is actually fasting. Thus, God says in Hadith Qudsi that fasting is for me and I only will reward it. End quote. In another hadith, the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, has said, quote, "If one does not give up falsehood in words and actions, God has no need of him giving up food and drink." End quote.
And back to our dear guest in the studio, Sheikh Hussein Al Jilani Alam, director at Al Azhar Mosque. What are the virtues of the holy month of Ramadan, Sheikh Hussein?
Yes, thank you so much for this important question, and also thank you so much for all of you for this very interesting and very informative report. Speaking of the virtues and the merits of the month of Ramadan, as a matter of fact, there are many important things, and also it brings to memory many pleasant occasions that happened to the Muslims, or and even to Egypt in particular, and the great people of Egypt in particular, many pleasant and many pleasing memories. So let's start off with the fact that it was during the month of Ramadan that the Quran started to be revealed to Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So you can clearly see that this is a very significant thing about the month of Ramadan itself, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen and selected this month, that month in particular, to be the time frame that contained the revelation of the month of Ramadan, and also how that not only, as a matter of fact, the Quran started to be revealed on Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, during the month of Ramadan, but also from reports from the part of Prophet Muhammad, we also know that the previous scriptures like the Torah and the Gospels, they also started to be revealed to the previous messengers and prophets during the month of Ramadan, which shows us how virtuous and how significant the month of Ramadan is. Another important and significant aspect, and which also serves as a motivation and as an encouragement and an incentive for us to be more indulged and more engaged in good deeds is the fact that it is during the months of Ramadan that a very important and a very significant night occurs, which is the Laylatul Qadr, or the night of power, or the night of decree. It is during which, as we have an entire chapter in the Holy Quran, which is named after this night, that doing good deed in or during this night in particular is rewarded as, or the reward itself is multiplied 1,000 times for any other worship established during any other time of the year. Another important also thing that also which is attached during to the months of Ramadan itself is that it is the night that the Prophet mentioned about which the Prophet peace be upon him mentioned that it is during which that the doors of heaven are open and the doors to hellfire and all evil is closed and locked, i.e. it is a very productive time, and it is a time which is more likely when it comes to prayers and supplications to be answered by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala out of His mercy and out of His wisdom. So this is also in and of itself an incentive for us to be more engaged on good deeds. And here a very important thing that I'd like to mention and share with our dear viewers when it comes to doing good deeds is maintaining the ties of kinship. Because, you know, due to the cares of life and how busy we get, we tend to not to care so much about maintaining the ties
family
of kinship
ties.
And all of this. So this is a time where we really need to think very much about maintaining our ties of kinship with our relatives and with our loved ones, and to check on them and to exchange visits with them, or we can all get together and have a family reunion and have dinner together or have suhoor together, because we know that maintaining the ties of kinship is a very has a very lofty status when it comes to Islam itself. So this is an opportunity that also we need to seize. So also when it comes to this blessed month of Ramadan, we know that many momentous occasions took place during the month of Ramadan, like the expedition of Badr, and how that after Muslims were persecuted and after Muslims had to get out of where they lived, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted them victory over the policies of Mecca, who persecuted and who tortured them. And also it was during the month of Ramadan that the great people of Egypt and their noble army also gained victory. So it's a month that has many momentous occasions to all Muslims and the Arab world and the people of Egypt.
Sheikh Hussein, what about fasting and productivity? Unfortunately, many people are using the holy month of Ramadan to stop working, to sleep more in order to...
As an excuse,
yes, to use it as an excuse. We are tired, it's hot, especially, of course, Ramadan is coming in the summer season, it's quite hot. And they are using that as a pretext to not to go to work, or even if they did go to work, they do not produce in a proper way. So how do you see that?
Well, as a matter of fact, this has nothing to do with Ramadan whatsoever. We know that the fasting of the month of Ramadan was even prescribed for previous nations. And it is, as a matter of fact, it is on the contrary, because during the month of Ramadan, we are spiritually elevated. And this per se drives for us more power and more willingness to get things done and to be more productive. And also it is time where our inner system and our digestive system in particular is more relief and more relieved and more at ease, so the rest of the limbs can more focus and be more productive. And when it comes to that, the people during the month of Ramadan are less productive. This is not due to the answer Ramadan, but as a matter of fact, this is because that many are of the habit of staying up all night and eating so much at the breakfast, so they get fill up with food and water, so they can.
And many
can
other others also, Sheikh Hussein, are so nervous, are having problems because of the bad habits of smoking or
smoking
drinking
and
too
now
much.
Now they need caffeine, the nicotine and the caffeine. So it is completely the opposite. So
it has nothing to do with Ramadan itself.
At all, yes. And and the one who will use or invoke this as an excuse, even when Ramadan is over, they will look for another excuse to justify their laziness and their improductivity. So this is something that we can not actually think of or to try to legitimize being less productive and laziness. No, this is a month for us to be even more productive. And as Muslims, we need to be as role models for everyone that during the month of Ramadan, we are at a higher moral standard and at a higher productive standard. And also, Ramadan serves as an educational institution for everyone and for all of the family members.
Yes. Dr. Hussein, it seems that we see during the holy months of Ramadan that people, they do go to work and they leave the work undone and they pray. Of course, it's a must that we pray, but we pray and return to work. But they stay, they read Quran or doing any rituals, and they do not perform the work. So well, how do you see that?
Thank you so
acceptable?
Much. Yeah, thank you so much for providing this point. Because many would think that they are excused not to carry out the obligations of their work, and they think that they are legitimized in this, that now this is time for just for remembrance and for reading Quran, and no, we cannot now fulfill all the requirements of our work. This is not allowed at all. Islam tells you, you need to first fulfill your job. Okay, when it's time for prayer, you can perform the obligatory, the obligatory prayer, but then go back to work, do and fulfill the needs of the people and other citizens. This is how you really get the best out of Ramadan. When you really observe and fulfill the needs of your work and you live up to the expectations of your job description while you are fasting, this is what you, this is the obligation. This is the primary requirement that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks you to do when your time work is over, and when you go back, when you go back to home, when you go back home, dedicate
all the time.
Exactly, yes. Dedicate all the time that you have for reading Quran, for dhikr, for prayer, for supplicatory prayer. But during the work time, this is a time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
You get paid for that.
Exactly,
work.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will hold you accountable, whether a man or a woman. They need to dedicate this time for their work requirements and fulfill their work requirements, and especially when it comes to the jobs and the types of work that that have to do with providing services for the people and for other citizens.
Indeed, sir. What about al-i'tikaf during the last 10 days of the holy month of Ramadan, or going into solitude and being just in relation with God? How do you see the importance of
that? Yes. As I said, one of the special and the merits of Ramadan is that it is a time during which performance of supplicatory prayers become more encouraged and more more rewarding. So one of these acts of worship is al-i'tikaf, or this retreat or solitude during the months of Ramadan. But here we really need to understand a very important thing, which we always are negligent of or we are unaware of, that whenever you enter the mosque during any time of the year, even if it's going to just be to pray the obligatory prayer, you can have in your intention as you enter the mosque the intention of i'tikaf. And for the time that you will be inside the mosque, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala,
even if it's only for the time of
exactly
performing
the prayer, be it for 10 minutes, for 15 minutes, this is also can be considered as i'tikaf. So performing i'tikaf or observing i'tikaf is also highly encouraged during the last 10 days of Ramadan. And a very important thing here is to understand that this should not serve as a precludement or as a hindrance for our productivity. As if we combine both intentions, that we fulfill the needs of our work and also to put food on the table and to provide for the needs of the family through halal means, and also observe i'tikaf, this is more rewarding, and this is what we as Muslims should be seeking and aspiring for.
Sheikh Hussein, how a person should emerge a better one after the holy month of Ramadan?
Yes, as a matter of fact, the institution of fasting itself serves as a training or as a disciplinary process for all of these 30 days. Because as you know, with the passage of time and throughout the year, we get distracted with things over here and there. So there comes the month of Ramadan to serve as a camp for us where we can dedicate our time and dedicate more time, as a matter of fact, to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And for this spiritual and for this intellectual recreation, and to recharge our spiritual battery, if you like. And also it is as much as when you prepare like policemen or when you prepare firefighters for challenges that they deal with in real life. So also before that, they need to be trained and they need to have mock tests in preparation facilities so that when they are up in front with these challenges in the real world, they are prepared and they are in a position. So this is also the case with fasting. During this camp of 30 days, we are prepared, we are equipped with the necessary means and with the necessary tools, so that when the month is over, we are in a position to maintain the spirit of Ramadan.
Hopefully that our dear viewers will maintain the spirit of Ramadan. Sheikh Hussein Eddine Alam, director at Al-Azhar Mosque, thank you very much, sir, for being with us. And with that, our dear viewers, we come to the end of this edition from Body and Soul. Hope you have enjoyed it. Until we meet again, my history, we are signing off, and have a happy and blessed Ramadan.